Great win for India. Tell us more about the highlights from this match.
Well, the highlight clearly has to be Ambati Raidu's 90 runs. He was under pressure when he came in with India struggling at 18 for 4. And he entertained that the crowd at the stadium with some sparkling stroke plays and thereby helping India set a target of 253 runs for New Zealand to win. Apart from that, we would say that the bowlers, in fact, the bowlers put up a power-packed performance. Mohammad Shami once again helping India get those early wickets, and then the spinners stifled the batsmen in the middle overs. Well, I'm joined by senior journalist G. Rajaraman on the show to discuss India's win. Raja, thank you very much for joining us on a day once again when India has won the series 4-1, their biggest series win in New Zealand. Would you say, going by the performance today, credit must go more to the bowlers in the way they defended the total, a small total, than, you know, Ambati Raidu, who got the man of the match?
No, I think crucially it was the middle order batsman who won the match for us today. Raidu played that good knock, as you pointed out, getting 90 under pressure. But more than him, perhaps, it was Hardik Pandya's blitz that set up India's win. Mm-hmm. When a batsman like him goes hammer and tongs, mm-hmm. what happens is it boosts the confidence of the Indian side. And at the same time, New Zealand would have been wondering what went wrong. Mm-hmm. And it helped India stage that fight back. I think today the credit should go to the middle order. Mm-hmm. 18 for 4 from there to set up a 250-plus target for New Zealand was a terrific effort, Rika.
We're also joined by Charu Sharma. Charu, would you say that India has now had a look at its 11 or maybe 15 for the World Cup, and Ambati Raidu perfectly fits in this slot?
I think 15 is a good call. 11 perhaps not, because even till the last minute, you never really know. And I shouldn't say this, but God forbid, every once in a while there are performance injuries or otherwise or whatever. So, yeah, let's not get to 11. But 15 for sure. I don't think too many holes at all. If there's one hole, it's perhaps in one or hole. The biggest problem would always remain with the medium pacers, because you need them fresh. You need them 100% in terms of fitness. And I think the fittest 3 or 4 will make it to the World Cup later this year.
Right. Raja, to you, Charu spoke about the medium pacers. Now, perhaps India is going to bring back Jasprit Bumrah. What really happens to the bowling combination right now?
I think it's an exciting headache to have for the Indian selectors and the team management. Mm-hmm. To have Bumrah, Bhuvneshwar Kumar and Shami bowling really well. Mm-hmm. And then to have someone like Umesh Yadav knocking at the door. And then you have got Hardik Pandya bowling so well, and then two spinners doing well. I think it is looking good for India from the bowling perspective. To answer your question about whether all problems have been or all the boxes have been ticked, I think the middle order is still a worry. Mahendra Singh Dhoni has scored a few runs in Australia and then in New Zealand as well. But the middle order remains a problem. India needs to address that and do a good job of it if it is to go a long distance in the World Cup.
Right, Charu, interestingly, Raja mentioned about Mahendra Singh Dhoni, his coming back into the side after that brief break. Would you say that really changed the energy of the side in the way, you know, he keeps leading the team from behind the stumps? That wicket that Kedar Jadhav took, and then later we saw that wicket again of another wicket of Jimmy Nisham. How MS Dhoni really set them up.
No doubt that he still belongs very much to the team. Let's not go by age and by other such apparent things. If you go by fitness and his contribution, he still very much belongs to the one-day sphere. You may argue that T20's strike rate is falling and we need more impact players there. But in the one-day internationals, remember, it's not just his runs or perhaps his work behind the stumps. Mm-hmm. It's much more his calm and his experience that the team can use every once in a while. Because mm-hmm. when ultimately teams are the same, what makes the difference? Mm-hmm. People like Mahendra Singh Dhoni and what they've done so far, their calm, their experience, makes the difference.